Namaskar and good afternoon to everyone. Today, I, Ricky Mishra, Director of Asiatic International Business Academy, welcome you all on this great and audacious platform of learning. It is well said that never stop learning, because when we stop learning, we stop growing. So with special excitement and eagerness to learn new things, I am pleased to welcome Ms. Shambhavi Singh Kaushik on behalf of the entire team of Aircrew Aviation Private Limited and Asiatic International Business Academy. It is an honor for me to introduce our special guest of the day in the International Webinar 2020. Ms. Shambhavi Singh Kaushik has done her education from renowned universities like Banaspati Vidyapeeth and Lucknow University. She believes in never give up principle, and currently she is working as a corporate relationship manager at Aircrew Aviation Private Limited, and she has worked as an aviation manager too. She loves to spend her leisure time in photography, interior designing, and decoration. Ms. Shambhavi, we all are glad to have you with us. Now it's all up to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Naina. And thank you, Mr. Shaikhar Shah, for inviting me and giving this a great opportunity for me for taking the session. And the topic for this session is aviation industry today and tomorrow. Okay, so am I audible to everyone?
Yeah, you are audible to
everyone. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So basically, firstly, I'll tell you what is aviation industry. The term aviation is most commonly used as to describe mechanical air transportation, which is carried out as an aircraft. And basically, there are two types of aircrafts, as aeroplanes and helicopters. So I'll be sharing a slide with you all. So wait a minute. Is my screen visible to everyone?
Yes.
Okay, so our next heading is, what is aviation industry? So the term aviation is mostly common, that I've actually told you, is used for mechanical air transportation. And the word aviation extends beyond this to include the use of unmanned aircraft such as drones. So people also get confused with aviation industry and airline industry. Actually, these are not the interchangeable terms. Aviation industry includes staff, manufacturers, researchers, and etc. And airline industry is just a part of a wider term aviation industry. Secondly, aviation industry, Also, there are two types of aviations. First is civil aviation and military aviation. Within the aviation sectors, there are two main categories of flight, that is civil and military. In simple terms, civil refers to all aviation that is not connected to the military. It includes private and commercial air travel, regardless whether flights are carrying passengers, cargo, or a combination of the two. In contrast, military aviation refers to the use of aircraft within military settings. Why is aviation industry important? Our next is, we can say aviation industry is important to us because it connects different countries and continents. It's easy for the cargo shifting. We can easily and as fast as we can reach to the different countries. It connects different cultures. Second is the globalized nature of the industry. it is globally spread. This industry is globally spread around. It make efficient travel to distant places. It is key contributor to global economic prosperity. As we can see from I think there was an internet issue. So the importance of modern aviation industry is difficult to overstate, but one of the main reasons for this importance is the globalized nature of the industry, helping to connect different continents, countries, and cultures. As a result, global aviation has been key facilitating aviation travel to distant places. Meanwhile, the aviation industry also directly provides millions of jobs for people around the world, with examples including everything from pilots, cabin crew, through to air traffic controllers and aerospace engineers. The next is the aircraft manufacturing companies. There are three large aircraft manufacturing companies within the aviation industry. First is the Airbus, second is the Boeing, and the last one is Lockheed Martin. Airbus, within you can see the pictures. The first one is the Airbus, the second one is the Boeing, and the third one is the Lockheed Martin. Airbus, within the aviation industry, Airbus is the large European aircraft manufacturing company which produces aircraft for both the civilian and military aviation markets. Its production facilities are located in France, Germany, Spain, while its headquarters are Netherlands. It is currently the world's largest airline manufacturer, while the Airbus A380 used by airlines like Emirates and Lufthansa is recognized as the world's largest passenger airliner. The second one is Boeing. Another large manufacturing company within the aviation sector is Boeing. Based in the United States, Boeing is generally classed as the second largest airline manufacturer, as well as being one of the largest defense controllers in the world. In addition to producing commercial and military jets, Boeing is also heavily involved in the manufacture of spacecraft. Some of its best known commercial aeroplane models include the Boeing 737 and Boeing 747 and Boeing 777. The last one is Lockheed Martin. It has its headquarters in Maryland in the United States. Within the aviation industry, Lockheed Martin is recognized as the world's largest defense contractor, specializing in military aviation and the production of fighter and reconnaissance. The company was formed through a merger between Lockheed Corporation and Martin Marietta, and some of its best known aeroplanes have included the F-16 Fighting Falcon and the F-35 Lightning II. Moving ahead, what are the types of airlines? There are three types of airlines: international, national, and regional. International, as the name suggests, operates through international bases, offering flights to multiple overseas destinations on the top of their domestic services. They are also known as major airlines. They include industry's biggest names such as American Airlines and Delta Airlines. The second is national. Although national airlines are smaller than their international counterparts, they may still offer some overseas services. However, they are primarily connected to single country, often with all of their main hubs there. They generally operate with a fleet of medium to large aircrafts and will bring in hundreds of millions in annual revenue while employing thousands of people. The third one is regional. Regional airlines are smaller than international and national ones, typically focusing on the kinds of areas they do not reserve much or any services from those airlines. In some cases, regional airlines partner with larger airlines, helping to transport customers to major hubs for connecting flights. The second one is largest airlines in the world. There are seven largest airlines in the world, and they are American Airlines, Delta Airlines, United, Emirates, Southwest, China Southern Airlines, and Ryanair. The first one is American Airlines, widely recognized as the world's largest airline, not only in terms of revenue passengers kilometers, but also in terms of fleet size and total passengers. American Airlines, with a fleet of close to 1,000 aircraft, flies to most of 100 international destinations and handles more than 200 million annual passengers. And the second is Delta. Within the aviation industry, Delta Airline is a legacy carrier airline, which has been offering passenger services since 1929. In total, the airline offers flights to more than 300 destinations spread across 50 different countries. Delta is also recognized as the largest member of the SkyTeam Airline Alliance, the United, offering passenger flights since 1931. United Airlines has a fleet of around 800 aircrafts, and it serves more than 300 destinations. It is widely recognized as the third largest airline in the world, and its headquarters is located in Chicago. United Airlines caters for more than 150 billion annual passengers and is a key member of the Star Alliance. The Emirates. Emirates is a state-owned airline based in the city of Dubai, United Arab Emirates. It has been offering passenger services since 1985, and in addition to being the fourth largest airline in the world. The airline operates with a fleet of more than 250 aircrafts, provide flights to more than 80 countries, and has its hub at Dubai International Airport. The Southwest. Southwest Airline is a low-cost airline within the aviation sector, which has been offering passenger services since 1971. The company headquarters is situated in Dallas, Texas, and it has a total of 11 crew bases throughout the United States. Then is the China Southern Airlines. China Southern Airlines has its headquarters in the city of Guangzhou and has been offering passenger services since 1988. The airline has a fleet of more than 600 aircrafts, provides flights to more than 200 global destinations. It has hubs at Beijing Capital International Airport, Beijing Daxing International Airport. And the last is Ryanair. Based in Dublin, Ireland, Ryanair is a low-cost airline within the aviation sector. Ryanair was especially notable for offering more routes and carrying more international passengers than any other airline in the world, even including the likes of American Airlines and Delta Airlines. The next one is main business model for airlines. The aviation sector is extremely diverse, and airlines in particular. So one of their four major business models are, first is they provide full services. Full services carriers are often either former state-owned flag carriers, which have since been privatized, or airlines which are still under state ownership. However, this is not always the case in all parts of the world. Instead, the defining characteristics. This means the passenger receives their baggage allowance and in any flight meals at no additional cost. Most full service carriers have a customer loyalty scheme rewarding frequent flyers, while lounge services at airport hubs may also be an offer. Example, American Airlines and Emirates Airlines. The second is low cost. As the name suggests, a low cost model is based around the idea of reducing operating costs and selling airline tickets. In-flight meals are not included with the price of ticket, with food and drinks sold separately on the flight. Passengers will also typically pay extra for baggage and may not book a specific seat on the plane. The third one is a charter. The charter business models tend to be focused very strongly on seasonal tourists, rather than selling individual airline tickets on passengers. This means that the charter airline will operate services to destinations with significant demand, and travel agents will try to book as many people on those flights as possible. One of the most notable examples of a charter airline is TUI Airways. In terms of services, they sometimes offer a middle ground between full services and low-cost models. The last is cargo and freight. Cargo and freight airlines are ideally primarily or exclusively involved in the transportation of goods via the air. These flights are often scheduled overnight. Well-known carriers that are exclusively focused on cargo and freight includes UPS Airlines, FedEx, Express, and DHL Aviation. So the future of aviation industry is basically that it has its boom period. We can see the basic data given. For a start, mobility actors should come together in a shared vision. This is where the World Bank led sustainable mobility. For the first time ever, SUM 411 provides the transport sector and its modes of transport within the opportunity to speak with one voice and jointly unpack a roadmap of actions. In addition, innovation in technology approaches cutting edge technologies such as autonomous devices and ultralight materials create opportunities to transfer the mobility system by enabling business models. In a little over a century, our industry has gone from learning to fly to learning to fly faster, learning to fly further, learning to fly higher planes, and now to have 1,000 plus commercial flights occurring around the world each and every day. Representing over 400 departures per hour, aviation has truly been at the forefront of innovation to become one of the safest and most reliable models of transportation in the world today. Sharing and leverage technology are the best practices from aviation, and all modes of transportation will help ensure the success and sustainability of emerging mobility sector, create trust by the public, and become sustainable. Within the 2030 agenda framework, ICAO was identified as the custodian agency of the global indicator for passengers and freight volumes by mode of transportation. The air transport is expanding and the future of aviation is bright one. In 2017, airlines worldwide carried around 4.1 billion passengers. They transported 56 million tons of freight and 37 million commercial flights. Every day, airplanes transport 10 million passengers and around USD 18 billion worth of goods. This indicates that significant economic impact on aviation on the world economy, which is also demonstrated by the fact that aviation represents 3.5% of the GDP, worldwide $2.7 trillion, and has created 65 million jobs globally. Aviation provides the only rapid worldwide transportation network, generating economic growth, creating jobs, and facilitating international trade and tourism. Aviation has become the enabler of global business and is now also being recognized by the international community as an essential enabler to achieving the UN Sustainable Development Goals. The aviation sector is growing fast and will continue to grow. The most recent estimates suggest that demand for air transport will increase by an average of 4.3% per annum over the next 20 years. If this growth is actually received by 2036, the air transport industry will then contribute 15.5 million in direct jobs and 1.5 trillion of GDP to the world economy. By mid-2030s, no fewer than 2 lakh flights per day are expected to take off and land all over the world. This growth is not limited to the passenger traffic. We participate that cargo traffic in terms of tonnage to continue to grow along a similar curve. The growing demand of air traffic involves challenges, not least of which are important logistically implications in and around airports to ensure their infrastructures. The main question which revolves around how we can achieve growth in a responsible and therefore sustainable way. As the industry plans to support a near doubling of passengers and cargo number by 2036, demand for pilots, engineers, air traffic controllers, and other aviation related jobs is expected to rise drastically. Worldwide, 51% of population lives within 100 kilometers of international airports, and 74% live within 100 kilometers of any kind of airports. So airspace is quickly becoming congested and air traffic is slated to double over the next 2 decades. In addition to airspace, we have to consider airports themselves. Airports are already built up around population centers and are already operating at high capacity. The reality is that in order to accommodate the forecast growth, drastic improvements and efficiency for airports, the air traffic management will need to be found. For this, we need innovation. Aviation is already known as a driving force of global technology development and innovations. Engines and aircraft become lighter, quieter, and more efficient. Emerging technologies are reshaping within the robotics, artificial intelligence, the Internet of Things, unmanned aircraft systems, and the push of hybrid electric planes. Alternative fuels can significantly change the current scenario of aviation in support of the environmental protection. The vast investment in artificial intelligence and big data could be seen as a promising way of increasing safety, efficiency, and sustainability. These technologies can help improve aviation infrastructures and airspace utilization. The aviation is now ongoing beyond mobility between continents and cities. It is starting to impact mobility within the cities. These innovations relate primarily to moving goods for now, but they will quickly become viable for moving people as well. The way of innovations in aviation will surely impact the wider transport sector as well as a 2030 agenda for sustainable development. These concepts show some examples of what the future has in store, from moving people to delivering packages. The innovations are truly amazing. If we want this future to become a reality, we need to ensure that everyone communicates, collaborates to make effective use of innovations. The future of mobility is literally taking off. So, okay, so this was the end of the session. So, is anyone has to ask something?